There are men and women who are afraid to worship. There are men and women who are afraid to go back to the war. There are men and women who are afraid to go back to the way of their life. There are men and women who are intimidated. But the Lord has already spoken a word that you shall live, you shall conquer, you shall be victorious in Jesus' mighty name. And the Lord is saying to me and to you, the church, a prophetic word for this season. Joel chapter number 20, verse number 25. The Bible says, the soul I will restore to you, the ear that swarming locusts have eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust, my great army which I sent among you. You shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be put to shame. Then you shall say that I am in the midst of Israel. I am the Lord your God, and there is no other. My people shall never be put to shame. Verse number 25, again I say, so I will restore to you the ears that the swarming locust has eaten, the crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust. So 2020, the second half of the year, I feel the Spirit of the Lord saying that this is going to be the season of restoration. This is going to be the season of restoration. Come on, somebody receive that word. This is going to be the season of restoration. I feel some people are already receiving it in their spirit right now. That this season, after what we've gone through, church, that this is going to be the season of restoration. I feel the Lord saying in my spirit that the remaining half of this year, that the remaining 6 months of 2020, that the Lord God is restoring things that the enemy has stolen from you. That the Lord God is putting back things in order, because the enemy has destroyed the world. Because the enemy has destroyed everything that God had put in place. And the Lord is saying that this year, as you trust in Him, as you put your faith in God, that He is going to restore what the enemy has stolen from you. That the enemy has stolen joy from the children of God. That the enemy has stolen wealth from the children of God. That the enemy has stolen your job. That the enemy has stolen your business. That the enemy has stolen your communication. That the enemy has stolen the way you worship. The enemy has stolen the way you do your Bible study. The enemy has stolen the way you have the freedom. The enemy has stolen your freedom. The enemy has stolen the way we communicate. The enemy has stolen the way we do things. But the Lord God Almighty is saying that all those 6 months that has been stolen, all those things that the enemy has stolen, that the Lord God Almighty, He is restoring them for His glory. Somebody shout amen. Somebody shout amen. Because the Lord is restoring you for your glory, for His glory. Because the Lord is setting you free again. Because the Lord God Almighty is putting courage instead of fear. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Bible says in the book of Joel that at this particular moment, that the kingdom of Judah has been intimidated. They have been worshiping the idols. They have been worshiping other gods. They were being ruled by the kings that did not know God. They were being ruled by the people that did not have the fear of God. And the church was distorted. The children of God did not have any courage. They did not have any fear of God. They had sinned against God. They had done things that God did not want them to do. But the Bible says that at that particular moment, that the Lord God allowed the locust to come to the land, and the locust was not even enough, that the first swarm of all locusts came and ate everything that they had. And when they thought that everything was over, a second swarm of locusts came and ate. And when they thought that everything was over, another kind of locust came. And the Bible says that everybody was devastated. Everybody was in fear. That sounds like 2020, when everybody is in fear. Wherever you go, every part of the world, nobody has the courage to start. No man has the courage to say what I'm saying. But the Bible says that God told them, that the God spoke to this prophet, a minor prophet by the name of Joel. Joel was not even known, but the Bible says that God spoke to him, and he said that this particular season, I am going to restore. Somebody say, restore. I am going to restore everything that the enemy has stolen from you. That I am going to restore everything that the devil has stolen from you. That I am going to restore. The Bible says that whatever the locust has eaten, the Lord says that the ears that you have lost through the locust, that the Lord God is going to restore. The enemy has stolen your marriage. The enemy has stolen everything, your children. The enemy has stolen your vision. The enemy has stolen your praise. But the Lord says the enemy has stolen your anointing. But the Lord says that this time around, I am going to restore whatever the enemy has stolen from you. I am going to restore in the mighty name of Jesus. And they did not believe it because it was too hard. Because the locust has eaten everything. The locust has devastated the land. The locust had put them to shame. But the Lord said that I am going to restore what the enemy has eaten, what the locust has eaten. And this year, 2020, as we come to the second half, I'm looking for somebody that will believe. I'm looking for somebody that will have faith. I'm looking for somebody that will trust God and say, God, yes, I know things has looked different, but God, despite of what is happening in the atmosphere, despite of the report that we are seeing, despite the chaos that are happening in the world, that God Almighty, I have chosen to know that you are restoring me. You are restoring me in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says that I will restore to you the ears that the swarming locust has eaten. The swarming locust are the one that comes and eats and destroys. And that's not enough. After those one that came in and swarmed the land, he brought another that was crawling in the land. And they were crawling in forms of fear. They were crawling in forms of intimidation. And right now as we live, there are people who are not even worried about COVID-19, but they are worried. They have been intimidated. They have depression. They have stress that has come because of everything that has happened. When the COVID is over, then they are struggling with another kind of locust. They are in lockdown. Even though they've been set free, their mind is still in prison. But the Lord says that after the cloning locust, then there was another one that is called the consuming locust. And the consuming locust are the one that comes. And because of lockdown, they consume even your saving. They consume even everything that you had in store before. They are nasty animals. After the consuming, after they've done all that, it was not enough. They brought another one that was called the chewing locust. And the chewing seems like they were mocking you. They've consumed everything that you have, and they're still chewing when you're watching. And right now, as we talk right now, church, there are people who are worried, there are people who are intimidated, there are people who are watching, and the enemy is mocking them at a distance. The enemy is mocking them at a distance. The enemy is mocking them at a distance. The Bible says that the children of Israel, when they were in Babylon, the Bible says that their tormentors were asking them, how can you sing a song of your God on your fallen land? Because the Bible says that it was there where they had hung their harps, they had hung their worship instrument. And their enemies were asking them, can you sing the song of your God? And they were asking themselves, how can we sing the song of our God on a foreign land? Does that sound like 2020, where even the worshippers have hung their instrument? Because the worshippers, they don't have the courage to worship. The worshippers, they don't have the courage to step up and say that in the midst of everything, that we are the hope of the world. The worshippers are devastated. The worshippers have given up. The ministers have given up. That people, they have led the news to dominate. They have led the fear to dominate. But the Lord is saying that in this year, somebody hear me, the second season, that the Lord wants the worshippers to rise up. The Lord wants the preachers to rise up. The Lord wants you and me to rise up on our feet and declare and decree that in the mighty name of Jesus, that we are going to worship the Lord even in the foreign land. We are going to worship the Lord even when our tormentors are watching. Even when the locusts that are chewing and mocking us, we are still going to worship the Lord. And somebody, wherever you are, put your hands together and bless the Lord and say, I am going to worship the Lord. So the chewing locust. But you see, that's not enough. The Bible says that my great army, which I sent among you. So that means that the Lord was aware when the locust was coming. He may not be the one that literally sent it, but he allowed it. Even when the enemy plotted, he allowed it to happen. And it seems like the church in the world and the community of the world, we've been so comfortable for the longest. We have relied on our own knowledge. We have relied on our own understanding. We have relied on our own finances. We have relied on the political powers. We have relied on our economical powers. But the Lord says that this year 2020, because it's going to be the year of great vision, that I am going to take away everything that you have relied on. I am going to bring and breathe, screw the deck, take everything off from you and see whether if everything that is taken off is taken off, can you be able to rely on me? If your good health is taken away from you, if your freedom is taken away from you, if your money is taken away from you, if your job is taken away from you, if your freedom to interact with others is taken away from you, can you be able to rely on God? Can you be able to have a vision and see what the Lord is doing? Or are you going to follow the crowd and be intimidated just like the children of Israel when they were getting up every morning and fighting the enemy Goliath waiting for them? Are you going to follow the crowd? Are you going to follow the same song and sing the song with others? Or are you going to rise up like David and say that who is this enemy that is intimidating the children of covenant? The Lord wants you to study the God. The Lord wants you to change your mindset so that you can be able to rely on him and him alone. Praise the Lord. For the Lord God to restore things, there are three things that I want you to remember. The knowledge of things that are happening in the world, the knowledge of the news, the knowledge, we acquire the knowledge from books, we acquire the knowledge from news, we acquire the knowledge from everywhere we go. That's knowledge. Knowledge, we acquire it, and we need to have knowledge. But then, do not rely so much on the knowledge. You also have to have understanding. And understanding, as the word under means, you have to know what is underneath. You have to know the reason for the knowledge to exist. The knowledge that you have to know the principles behind that knowledge. We got to have the understanding of the times and seasons. We have to have the understanding of what is happening in the world right now. We got to have the understanding of the season and the time that we are living in right now. Because if you do not understand the times and the season, like the children of Isaac, the Bible says that the sons of Isaac were the sons of understanding. They were able to discern and to understand the time and season. So if you do not understand this time and season, you're going to be frustrated, you're going to be always down. But you got to have the understanding. On top of knowledge and understanding, you got to have the wisdom. And that's where now revelation comes in. Because wisdom is the application of the acquired knowledge and understanding, and you put it into practice. And it requires a lot of revelation for somebody to have wisdom. Now, what's happening in the world right now, what is happening in this season right now, so many people have knowledge about COVID-19. So many people. They have a lot of knowledge because news are everywhere. And some people, they also have a lot of understanding about COVID. They can tell you everything about COVID. They have the understanding. But what people are lacking is the wisdom, which is the application of the knowledge and the understanding that you have. And know that as a child of the Most High God, if the Lord God has said that He's going to restore whatever the locust has eaten, even with the knowledge and the understanding, you have a revelation to know that you are still hidden under the blood. That even though there's COVID and you have the understanding, you do the ordinary what the government has asked you. You keep the social distance. You sanitize yourself. You make sure that everything is okay. But when we come to that particular way of worshiping God, you cannot stop worshiping God because there's COVID. Because the Bible says that let everything that has breath praise the Lord. And as far as you're breathing today, you've got the duty and obligation to praise the Lord. The enemy wants you to be intimidated. The enemy wants you to seclude yourself. The enemy wants you to isolate yourself. But the Lord God is saying otherwise. He's saying that you've got to come out. You've got to have the wisdom and know that even though everything else is shaken, the foundation of wisdom will still remain. That God will never change. Situations will change. But our God will remain the same God yesterday, today, and forever. COVID will come and go, but our God is still the same. Hallelujah. Protesters will come and go, but our God will remain the same. You may lose your finances. You may lose your job. That is a season that will come and go, but our God will remain the same. The love of our God toward me and you is constant. That our God will never change. That God will always be there for you. Praise the Lord. That our God will be there for you. Now, as we continue to verse number 28, it says that when the Lord restores everything, it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. So this is when everything is said and done. When everything is said and done. Let's first of all go to verse number 27. We see what's going to happen before the Lord pours the spirit upon the people. Then the Lord says, verse number 26. After the Lord restores what the enemy has stolen, after what the locusts have stolen, you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. Praise the Lord. After this season, I declare that from today until the end of this year, that you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Is there somebody who was not eating in plenty? Is there somebody who was not satisfied? Is there somebody that you know that your finances have been taken and you have not been having plenty? It's going to be the season of plenty and you'll be satisfied. And then the other says, and praise the name of our God. So it's going to be the season of plenty, number one. The second one will be the season of praising. You're going to be half plenty and you're going to be praising the Lord. And everybody will be looking at you and will be wondering, why is this person so happy? It's because the Lord will open avenue for you that you're going to have something, you're going to have plenty, and you're going to be praising His name. It's going to be a season of praise. Amen?
Amen.
And then it says, you're going to be praising the Lord who has dealt wondrously with you. So it's going to be the season of wonder. Amen. I say, number one, it's going to be the season of plenty. Number two, it's going to be the season of praise. And number three, it's going to be the season of wonder. Amen. And number four, and my people will never be this put to shame. It's going to be the season where the Lord will take away the shame from you. Somebody better receive that word in their spirit. That it's going to be the season of plenty. It's going to be the season of praise. It's going to be the season of wonders. And it's going to be the season where the Lord will take away the shame from you. Then you shall all know that I am in the midst of Israel. That God will know that He's the Lord God of JICC. That people will know that He's the Lord God that we serve. And I am your God, and there's no other God, and my people will never be put into shame. You are not going to be ashamed. The Bible says that it's going to be a season of plenty. May somebody receive that word in Jesus' mighty name. Number two, it's going to be the season of praise. I pray that the Lord God Almighty will open your voice again that you can praise Him. If somebody has been, if this praise has been stolen away from you, I pray that the Lord God will restore that praise in the name of Jesus. I pray for the restoration of the anointing of praise in this house in Jesus' name. And the Lord God will give wonders with you. It's going to be a season of wonders in your life. Those people who the enemy has stolen their joy, then the Lord will give you wonder that you're going to have joy in the presence of the Most High God. And those people who have been put to shame, I pray that the Lord God will roll away your reproach, that God, you're not going to be ashamed anymore. Is there somebody today who is standing in this house? Is there somebody who is listening to me online or wherever you're watching me from? Is there somebody who has gone through the season of shame? That is something that has ashamed you. Every time you try to look, it look like a giant that has ashamed you. And the Lord is saying that this season that we are starting, this season that we are starting right now, that God will make sure that you are not going to be put into shame in Jesus' mighty name. And the Bible says that afterward, it shall come to pass that I will pour my spirit upon all flesh, that your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and that you and me, your old men shall dream, your young men shall see vision, and also my man servant and my maid servant, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and I will show wonders in the heavens and in earth, blood and fire and the pillars of the smoke, and the sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into the blood before the coming of the great and awesome day of the Lord. And it shall come to pass that whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That even though there's fears outside, even though there's killed, even though people are dying, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Hallelujah. The Bible says that whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Jesus, we call upon your name today. We know things have been tough. But God Almighty, you've said that this season around, that you're turning things for your people, oh God. That, Lord, we are entering into a new season, a season of restoration. We pray for our finances to be restored. We pray for the ministry to be restored. We pray for families to be restored. We pray, Jehovah God, for marriages to be restored. We pray, Father Lord, for joy to be restored. We pray for our children to be restored, Jehovah God. We pray that, God, you may restore the peace in the world. We pray for restoration right now. Holy Spirit of God, have your way. I speak a word of restoration upon their life. For those who are watching me, I speak a word of restoration upon their life. For those, Father Lord, who have lived in shame, I declare and decree no more shame in the mighty name of Jesus. That God, somebody at this time and hour, oh God, at this time last next year, oh God, they'll be rejoicing with a great miracle in Jesus' mighty name. As we come, Lord, for this season, oh God, the second half of this year, I pray that the glory of this season will be greater than what we have experienced, oh God. Holy Spirit of God, we thank you because, God Almighty, you have dealt with your people, oh God. You've said that, God, we're going to have a season of prayer, a season of praise. And you said, Jehovah God, that we are going to have that season, that, God, you are going to roll away reproach. You're going to take away shame from your people. It's going to be a great, a wondrous season for your people. May your people go in peace, oh God. May your glory shine upon them. Let your peace be upon them, oh God, as they worship you. May you restore them to yourself. We give you glory. We give you honor. For we pray this in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and everybody in this house say, Amen. Amen.